Scott, I have a little video of the strategy that I want you to use for your mission. It involves this plasmid PAT-113, and the advantage of it is mostly for us that it has this thing called ORI-T-RK2, stands for origin of transfer, and what it means is that this plasmid, when introduced into E. coli, can then potentially transfer that plasmid into other strains, including gram-positive, including something like Bacillus or Enterococcus or maybe even C. difficile, ultimately. And it has this multiple cloning site. So we had talked yesterday about using HindI3 and SAL, which is right here, but I'm thinking that we're better off using this SPH1 and HindI3 site for the cloning. And that's because over here, the insert that we want to introduce, which has the GFP reporter here, there's a region right here that has the C. difficile promoter that we want to measure the expression of, a plasmid called UA321. We have PCR primers, one of which is going to be recognizing the sequence right about here. That's called TP002. And then we have another primer that would anneal right around here. It's called OPPRO-R. So that if you do PCR from those two primers, what you'll end up with is a linear fragment that has the reporter gene on it, so that we can measure gene expression by fluorescence, which is really easy. It has the region of C. difficile that we want to measure in the first place, that promoter. And it would, because the primers are on the outside of this SPH1 site right here and this HindI3 site right here, it would have those sites in it. So they would be kind of like here and here. Right there or so. So then if we digest those with those enzymes, or digest that PCR product with those enzymes, then we'll end up with sticky ends for SPH1 and HindI3. And that would allow us to ligate that fragment directly into the PAT-113. So I'm thinking that today we should try the HindI3 SPH1 digest of the plasmid that you isolated earlier in the week and just see if those two enzymes work or are compatible. And if they are, then we can do the PCR next week and continue with the ligation reaction and all that good stuff.